Welcome to Tutu's Haw-lay. Today I am doing a color combo that is being put on by a Facebook group that I'm a member of called Makers of Mixed Media Art / Artist. And it is ran by pmartiststudio, which is a mother and daughter team. P is for Patricia, M is for Mariah. And they do four lives weekly, and they're a lot of fun to watch. And the chat's a lot of fun, so I feel like one of the reasons why I started this channel was to connect with other creative people who enjoy art and who can relate to or have the same mindset. Enjoy art and all the possibilities and share a love of creating. So with that said, we're going to get started. I had started playing around earlier. I don't normally plan the videos. I usually just get on here and wing it. But these colors were, for some reason, putting a, giving me a little bit of a mental block. I don't know. Maybe it's because it's not normally colors I would reach for to put together. I can kind of see putting yellow and brown together, but yellow, brown, and pink. So the three colors, and last year when they were doing it, they would only do two colors, but this year they added a third color, and then they do give you a couple of colors, like neutral, that you can use to finish your project. So I had an idea of something that I want to do, but I needed some jelly prints. And let's be honest, any excuse to play with a jelly plate, I'm there. So I was playing around a little bit, and I also, like I said, this is not colors I normally reach for. It's not something, you know, that are my go-to. So I had a bunch of little different kinds of acrylic tubes that I need to just use up some of this stuff. So I thought, what way to better do it than get out the jelly plate and start using some of the paint. And at the same time, I can complete the color combo for the month of January. They have several challenges and things that they do each month, and they started some new things this year, so I'm looking forward to it, excited about it. Let me turn this way. So what I'm going to do here is I want to kind of, I don't really want to mix the colors all together, but I want to kind of have a random pattern to play with, but at the same time have it to where you can see all of the colors. That's not good. Okay, so the first one. And you know, it kind of sometimes takes the gel plate a minute to warm up, or maybe it's me that is doing the warming up. So anyway, I was playing with this a little bit and thought, man, why am I not filming this? I could be knocking two things out at one time. Again, getting a video, and then hold on a second. It's hard to multitask and get it all done at the same time. I don't want the paint to dry. Oh, knock out a video, complete a part of the challenge. After I get the gel prints made, I have an idea of what I want to do, but I would like to do it in my art journal. So I will have it. So get this done today, and then hopefully maybe either later tonight or tomorrow. It's the weekend, it's Friday. I'll be able to finish it up in my art journal. So, how's everyone's New Year's going so far? I know mine has been busy. I have not been on film in, gosh, it's probably been 9 or 10 days. There's been so much going on, and with the end of the year, and the grandkids went back to school on Wednesday. So that has made things a little quieter around here. So I absolutely love that. And then another one I was playing with. So I'm gonna try this. I haven't tried it this particular way yet. And I did pull out like 3 different shades of pink. This is a peach pink, or they're calling it a peach pink. Sorry if I get quiet. Sometimes I get lost in this, and I'm trying really hard to stay situated in front of the microphone, because I watched my last video and realized I kept walking away or moving my face away from the microphone. I had a piece of tissue paper here. What did I do with it? I bought this. I was trying to get some more wet strength carnival or wet strength tissue paper from Amazon, and they've been out of it for so long. I mean, can't. So I tried, was going to try this as a replacement, but to me this feels and appears to be more like deli paper that maybe, you know, you'd package meats or something in. It's shiny on one side, waxy, I guess, would be a better word, waxy, and then not waxy on the other side. I mean, it picks up okay, but I just wonder what the longevity is. I should probably save the darker color for to pull it. So we put pink down. Now we'll do yellow. But this, let's see if we try to pull it with brown. We'll see. No mistakes, just happy accidents. Isn't that what Bob Ross used to say? But even the brayer off paper is coming out looking kind of cool. So, did anyone set any New Year's resolutions? Are you already starting to, are you sticking to it? You know, most years people set them and then a week or so down the road and, oh, cool. Okay, we need to let that dry. I wish this was a 9x12 plate, because then I would have just done it directly in my art journal. Okay, we're gonna try to pull this with brown, which we'll see if that works out. It's not quite dry enough yet. So let me, pause you, hold please. Okay, so back to, did anyone set any goals? really would like to try this year to do something, whether it be big, small, whatever, something creative every day. I think that not only will that help with stress levels, because this is usually the time that I de-stress. But I also feel I have been doing a lot of thinking the older I get about, you know, enjoying life. We never know how long we have here. Okay, let's see if this is going to come out. Ah! Hope everyone had a good New Year's, good Christmas. I do have some, I did get a few art supplies and or gift cards and art supplies for Christmas, so I feel blessed. Okay, the brown probably should have been the first color, so we may have to do this again. Yeah, that's a whole lot of brown. Let me try. I'm gonna put some pink and yellow down and then try to pull on top of that. Let's see if that'll help it out there. And look at that, I'm probably gonna use all of that pink today, which is a good thing. Another thing I would like to do is, I was watching Laura from the Half-Ass Crafter, and she is talking about using all of her stuff. And then it was funny, because at one point she was saying, you know, at one point we bought this stuff because we liked it, so why not use it? Okay, let's see if we can... get in all of these little crevices. And then try to pull it. Hopefully it's not too dry. See if this works. You always have to try, right? You never know. And anyway, you're not gonna mess anything up. You can always fix it, tear it up, use it for a collage. One thing you know, we were stationed in Germany for, well, we did two different tours in Germany. And I will say that our first tour in Germany was the first time that I'd ever seen real snow. And what I mean by real snow is when you go outside and it's up to your knees and, you know, cars are buried in it. And where was I going with that? Oh. Being in Hawaii, we don't really get snow. But what I was going to say is I have been enjoying that the weather is kind of, that's okay. I don't really love it, but it might make a good background for something. I think the brown is really throwing me off. I don't think it's really doing anything for me. Unless maybe I keep it. Let me try this. Doing it blotchy, maybe. Well, I've been enjoying. Let me finish my thought process. The weather has been a little cooler. I mean, I think it's still like the typical 82 degrees. I don't think that's changed. But it's been a little windier, and maybe what it is it's not as humid, so it has been feeling a little bit cooler, which is kind of nice, because usually you're just hot and sweaty. I'm not complaining. Look at me trying to do this without getting way ahead of myself. Okay, I'm gonna try to get this on here really blotchy looking. Now we're ready for the stencil. And then there will be another video, because I'm gonna take some of these papers we're making and hopefully get something in my art journal, but also complete the other two, other two challenges, or I don't know if you really call them challenge. I guess they call it a color combo challenge. And then where I was going with the new year is I hope all of the content creators out there that work so hard at their channels do great this year, and that they get what they're looking for. And then with that said, I wanted to segue into thank you to everyone who has subscribed to my channel and who watches the videos and gives thumbs up. I mean, I know you don't have to do that, and I know that, but it does help get my channel out there, get my name out there, and I'm not really sure where I'm going with this channel. I started it, like I said earlier, to kind of get to know some other arty people, or people that just like to play with art materials. You don't have to be I've always kind of dabbed in painting, but I've never had any professional training. So recently I've been looking at some classes online and thinking about maybe at the age of 59, maybe by the time I turn 60, taking some art classes. Ooh, I kind of like that. That could make an interesting. Oh, I don't want it to stick. No. I'm just going to save this one. Sorry, guys. Stick it over here where it'll dry. What do you think? Do you like that one? Okay, what do we pull this with? It's not going to cause it to look muddy. Let's try pulling it with some white. So they do give you a couple of other colors you can use. It's not the three colors of the it's black, white, and I think one metallic. So you can use one metallic white and black on top of the three colors that are the color combo. And I have seen on the Facebook group, Makers of Mixed Media Art and Artist, there's been a few people that have already posted the things that they've made, and there's some really creative people and really arty people. So if you're looking for a Facebook group that has people that like art, love art, you know, want to do it in their pastime, I highly, highly recommend Makers of Mixed Media. And the mother and daughter team that run that are just so nice, and they, you know, want to support everybody, lift people up. They are, it's not self-centered in any way, but I'm talking them up right now because they're really trying hard to, they're really close to 8,000 subscribers. And to me, that just, oh my gosh, I don't even know if I'd ever be able to get that high. It would be like, oh, I'd walk on clouds. But anyway, if I could help somebody else get there, and if I reach somebody that joins in on their lives or goes to, even if you just want to do the Facebook group, there are so many, I've met several people in there that I really think I could be friends with, that I could relate to, and they've been so welcoming, so supportive, so nice. Okay, so we see the brown and the yellow. I don't really see the pink. I mean, a little bit, but the brown is still taking over. Why does that remind me of a song, Taking Over? Okay, let's move this out of the way and see if we can use one of these papers that we have already. Maybe we could. Maybe we could. Oh. I want to get rid of this white. Or do I could always make this look like a frame. Okay, maybe we can take some of this brown. This was not planned, guys. I'm just going with it. Actually, I have a little piece here, scrap. This is something I got off of Amazon. It was on a roll. And I've used it quite a few times already. I think I've already used it. Oh, yeah, I know I did. I used it in a video for December. I'm just going to cut this. Here goes that indecisive. Or is that called intuitive art? Going with the flow. That's what we're doing. Let me see, how do I want this? Am I gonna cut this? Yes. Let me get my cutter so I can straighten it up, make sure it looks. I do want to put this in my art journal, so hopefully I can get it looking halfway decent, right? need the bigger cutter. I'll just cut it by hand. Just bring it out, Tammy. Okay, maybe we could just get the whole thing done right now. Okay, here's the art journal. Looks really small in there, doesn't it? I'm gonna have to figure out what to do with the frame. But for right now, what did I do with the brown piece that I cut? Oh Lord. You know what I could do? I really don't know what I did with the piece I had laying. Okay, I'm sure it'll show up. In the meantime, we'll cut another one. See, there's the wind that we're getting that we typically don't get a whole lot of. Okay, I need some matte medium and a way to put it on. Be able to get this. Oh, yep, there it goes. Well, I know I've used this before. Why is it? Did it just come out of the top, I guess? Oh, do I need this on there? So I was talking about this stuff that came on a roll. It has been a lot of fun, and actually got me up off the couch a couple of times just to play with it, because I kept thinking about different things to do with it. Now, I've never tried to glue it down like this. Well, yes, I did on the one at Christmas time. Okay. We will let that dry. And then I think what I would like to do is try to brayer some Let's see if I can get that from there. Shirt. Well, that didn't work like I thought. Maybe it needs to be painted on there. Let's try it this way. That's why you use a gel. Looks better. Before I get too wrapped up in that. Yeah, no, not liking that. Oh, I know what we could use. Let's see which one. Let's try this. Now this is something else, this stencil butter that I'm really starting to really like. But the first time I've seen that I saw someone use this was on PM Artist Studio. So another reason why I like watching them is because they are always, well not always, but they use supplies that I have never been exposed to. Like my grandson would say, meh, meh. Do I have a stencil here that we could try this on? Because now I really want to try this. Ooh. I wonder if this would work. Is that too much like that? Here we go. Here we go. I'm not sure I like that pearl looking color though. How about we change it over to copper? Ooh. I've never used this one. Oh yeah, it looks like it works better on a stencil. Now, I have used some of the stencil butter, not this color, but when it dries really hard. So you probably want to, if you use one of your stencils, make sure you wash it off fairly quickly so that you don't mess up your stencil. Gosh, having a hard time with words, can you tell? This is gonna be my metallic. Can I get away with that? I think so. Let's see what that did. Yeah, it's different. I feel like we need just a little bit more maybe over here. Like one side is heavy. Okay, let's see what we have so far. That's not entirely dry. When it's dry, I'm going to let me see, what else can we do? What can we do? Let me close all this up before I make a big mess. Now, if we took this, let me pause you for a second and go wash this off because I think I want to actually, I think I'll leave it like this for now and let this dry. Maybe this could be glued here. And then, what if we take some of this pink? And do I have a card here that I could use? Okay, I think I'm just gonna try to put some of the colors on here with the palette knife. And then I think I'm gonna come back on it and write Cuddler Combo Challenge. And then these would be the three colors that were All right, we'll see what we have here. There was no plan for this, just so you guys know. Yeah. Looks like it's going off the page. Have to know where to cut this. If I make it on the side. I'm looking around the table to see if I have anything else here. Or maybe what I could do is put it up some more. Nope. Okay, guys. I am gonna stop this video for today and for now, at least I should say, but I'm going to go ahead and close it out just in case I don't get back to it. But if you made it this far, I appreciate you watching. Thank you so much. Don't forget to go and check out Makers of Mixed Media Art and / Artist. And then I need to go ahead and stop this for now so I can clean up my stencil and my tools so they don't, so this stuff doesn't dry on here and mess up my tools. Okay, guys, hope everyone's having a great start to their new year. Hope to see you again soon. And thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Everyone have a great day. Have a great weekend if I don't talk to you again. And take care, guys. Bye.